Hello and welcome to our workshop. Today we're going to be introducing a new product, the PT Solutions ProtoShield. As you might have guessed by the name, this is a prototyping shield intended to be used with Arduinos and similar microcontrollers. The PT Solutions ProtoShield is packed with features. So today's video we're going to be discussing these features, break them down, and at the end of the video we're going to show a couple of examples. So let's get right into it. Taking a closer look at the ProtoShield, the first thing somebody might notice are these two central rails running left to right. Initially, these rails are disconnected, but the user can configure them. One way they might do so is by connecting this option, or this option. The first option here is labeled ground, and when bridged, connects the ground pin to this upper central rail. The bottom central rail has two options. It can either be 5V or 3.3. If the user desires, they can just leave these open and use these rails for anything else that they want. One way that we suggest to connect these if wanting to use the voltage options here is to use a 2x3 pin male header, put it right through like this, and then to use these two pin jumper caps and make temporary connections. This way you have a lot of flexibility in using ground, V5, 3.3V for one project, but then changing that for a different project. So you get a lot of flexibility in usage out of this shield. Now let's take a look at all the other default electrical connections. First of all, note that all electrical connections are indicated by white dashed silkscreen lines. So for example, we've got a row of four right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and they're electrically connected with one another, and it's indicated by these three white dashed lines between each of the holes. In that similar fashion, we get a whole bunch of four pin breakout rows at the upper side of the central rails, and we have a whole bunch more at the lower side. Similarly, we have other rails. We have a rail up here that goes from this point to here. It breaks in the middle and then continues. Just underneath that, we have a rail that goes the entire length. And similarly, at the bottom, we have a rail here. It breaks here, and that breaks, and a little one over here. You might have noticed that there are three through holes that are marked with these diamond-shaped silkscreen printing here, here, and here. These are electrically connected to each other, and they're very useful if you want to bring a signal from up here from one of these breakouts, and you want to bring it down here without having to run a wire across all of this section. Or maybe you want it over here, so you can tunnel the signal from here to here. Speaking of breakout sections, we should know that this shield breaks out each of these pins that come from the Arduino below. So the SCL has a breakout right here, the SCA, and all of them at the top. Similarly, all of them at the bottom. So every single pin is available with at least one breakout. The final breakout is on the top left corner over here. This is for the SOIC. It can accommodate surface mount ICs with a pitch of 1.27 millimeters. And a pinout of up to 7 rows, so 2x7. The first pad here is labeled with a 1, and that 1 corresponds with this breakout over here. All other of the 14 breakouts follow the exact same order as the pads themselves. As an example, this is the famous 555 timer. It has many applications, and there are many example tutorials on how to use this very fundamental IC. It can easily fit on this breakout here, and then you can use it. Next, let's focus our attention to the bottom left corner of the board over here. This is for inputting or outputting general purpose signals, with few of them already hardwired. The footprint itself is designed to accommodate a standard 8-pin screw terminal like this one, with a pitch of 2.54 millimeters. That's the standard pitch. However, you could also use a header pin, a male or female header, whichever is convenient. We can see that the first pin is marked as ground. It is already connected to ground, and there's nothing to do for the user. The next one is 5V. The third pin is our first general purpose pin, GP1. You can see a white line connecting to the pin over here, indicating there's an electrical connection between these two. This is the breakout of GP1. The user can connect this to any signal that they want to input or output to their project. Next up, we have GP2, another ground. Then we have 3.3V. Note, this one is 5V, and this one is 3.3V. And then we got GP3 and GP4. Each of the general purpose input-output pins are connected here, 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 and here. So the user has four of them that they can configure in any way that they like. And finally, last but not least, we have this footprint over here at the top left corner of the PCB. This is an I2C breakout where we have the first pin being the ground, then 5V, then SDA, and then SCL. This is the I2C bus connection. The footprint is such that a standard 4-pin screw terminal can fit into here, but again, you could use a pin header such as a male or female pin header. This brings me to a discussion on compatibility. This board, the ProtoShield, is compatible with the following Arduino boards. We've got the Uno, which is a 5V board, the Leonardo, the Mega, and also the Duet. The Duet is a 3.3V board. The logic level is at 3.3. So therefore, it is fully compatible with these boards, and it is a full stacking board as well. We should note that SDA and SCL lines will be at 5V if using the Uno, the Mega, or the Leonardo, but these will be at 3.3V if you're using the Duet. So the user should be aware when they're connecting something here through the I2C bus that those voltages will change. Note, however, the 5V does remain 5V even on the Duet. So there you have it. As you can see, the ProtoShield is packed with features. These features are designed to add a lot of flexibility to your projects. And it's only your imagination is the limit of what you're going to do with this. As an example, we've prepared two different shields. This first shield here is a type of sensor shield. Here we have a temperature and pressure sensor, and here we have an accelerometer. Note that both of these sensors work on 3.3 logic when they communicate with the I2C bus. So we also included a logic level shifter. So this shield is compatible with Arduinos that run on 5V logic, such as this Uno. We also have used the central power rails and connected them to ground and 5V with the 2-pin jumper method that we explained earlier. We also installed stacking headers all the way around. It can easily interface with the Arduino, like this. And there you go, that's it, that's the sensor shield. The other shield over here is a LCD shield. So if you want to print out the results from the temperature, the pressure, or the accelerometer, you can just plug it in on top of that. Note that this shield does not have the stacking headers. Instead, it has just regular headers. And this is because this is not intended to be in the middle of a stack, but rather it's intended to be on the very top. So now we have the printout of anything that we want, including the shield underneath. So there you have it. Those are just a couple of examples, and there are countless more. We hope this video has been useful in demonstrating the features of the ProtoShield.